Hi everyone, I'm Sycamore Omega. Today we're going to take an updated look at the constellation Aquila in Star Citizen 3.1. In the future, I plan to continue to update my reviews and opinions as features are added to ships throughout the development, and the constellation Aquila will be my first one. The constellation Aquila has been a staple of the Star Citizen Pledge store for a while as one of the larger ships that backers could purchase regularly. For a while, it was priced at $275, but with the release of 3.1, this price increased to $310. We know that prices for ships will increase as we get closer to a full release. It made sense that as more features came into the ships, that more capabilities are being purchased. This is logical comparing it to early access games where prices increase as features are added. For example, I bought Kerbal Space Program for $20 when it was barely a game. Now the same product costs $40, and I can do a lot more with it. Ships work the same way until they can no longer be purchased. However, I'm sure that ships like the Constellation line will be available for purchase as game packages after full release. All that being said, I expected to get a little more value out of my Aquila with 3.1, considering the price increase. So what has changed? To be honest, not a lot. It looks like the team have added some interface screens to the engineering section and are experimenting with display screens on the bridge to best address visibility issues on HUDs. For example, MFDs in the pilot position are now solid LCD type screens rather than the transparent glass. While these screens are not huge, this change does reduce visibility on the bridge, a setup that already is complained about for poor visibility. I don't think the Aquila's bridge visibility is the worst, but the solid screens do it no favors either. In 3.0, these MFDs were a smoke transparent glass, but wasn't dark enough, and at times the text was hard to read. The co-pilot stations also have these new type screens for their main displays, which are really not great. These stations are not only to perform technical tasks using displays, but must be able to have a similar view out of the bridge. If these stations are not for this purpose, then why have them three abreast across the bridge? I'm hoping that this will be changed again in 3.2 because these are really disappointing solutions to a display visibility problem. At this point, in 3.1, the Aquila does not perform any of the exploration tasks planned. This is to be expected though, as there was nothing planned in 3.1 for exploration functions. Missile racks are functioning better in 3.1, and the Aquila is a little easier to use in combat now that the cannons are not your only weapon. There have been some lighting changes made to try to bring the interior more in line with the Andromeda variant when the power is off, primarily the auxiliary blue lights. This still needs some polishing on the Aquila. Lights often glitch through the geometry and snap on and off when doors open or close. Also, there are some issues with light leaking in some areas from outside, like the area where the Merlin is docked and main elevator when the power is off. Some texture changes have been made to the doors and various panels that look very good, and animations have improved for most doors and functions. While we now have working missiles again, we also have a graphical glitch where missiles are outside of their launchers on the starboard side. It's minor, but it's annoying to look at these in the external view. Additionally, the engines now have a cool lighting effect that adds kind of a glare to the camera in external views. I hope this gets propagated to more ships in the future. So, do these improvements justify a $35 price increase in 3.1? I don't think so. If there were functional additions to the ship, I would get it, but everything that was done were minor things to fix problems that were overall requirements. I have no additional abilities in 3.1 than I did in 3.0 other than less bridge visibility and missiles. I think CIG jumped the gun a little with the price increase. Maybe if the Merlin was flyable out the back or storing the Ursa inside was automatic, or even if secondary stations had new functions. These would be features that would make the Aquila a better ship than others in the release and would justify the increase. Now, don't get me wrong, I get why ships cost more when they're released into the game rather than concept, but for an existing non-limited ship to increase, there needs to be reasons rather than animation and UI changes. The Gladius got a similar treatment to the Aquila, but it wasn't raised in price. Now, I'm going to put my tinfoil conspiracy hat on, but I feel like the price increase was more related to the 600i updates, where for the first time I heard it compared to the Aquila. I'm not saying that they said the Aquila is a bad ship by any means, but I think they wanted to bring the price points closer together to under $100 to try to entice more people to upgrade when the time comes, especially how they describe the Constellation as slow compared to the 600i. It just introduces a sense of inferiority of players that may have just spent over $300 for a ship. What's an extra $90 later for a ship matched in class but better according to designers? I won't be upgrading my Aquila to a 600i mainly because the 600i doesn't seem to be in my taste. I like the grit of the Constellation line. It sends a message of space is hard and industrial, the Phoenix excluded. That line in the update seemed like a pretty transparent marketing ploy, though. Okay, tinfoil hat off. So the Aquila is still the fun medium ship it was in 3.0, and the continued development on it is great to see. I like being reminded that these ships haven't been forgotten, and development is experimenting with solutions for common problems. Currently, the Aquila is my regular delivery mission ship and trading ship, because it's fun, it's the right size, and it's great to look at in-game. Occasionally being interdicted can be a fun little challenge, especially when you're fighting off multiple ships. Lastly, I reevaluated the Constellation Aquila's performance using better methods than in my 3.0 review to get a more accurate dataset. Looking at pitch performance first, the Aquila has a minimum effort pitching radius of 1.4 kilometers at 7.7 degrees a second. A 354 meter turn radius is achieved at half effort, and at maximum effort, the Aquila demonstrates a wide 136 meter turn radius. These numbers are similar to what I measured in 3.0, and the variation is likely due to my original testing methodology. In yawing maneuvers, the Aquila is capable of a 2.1 kilometer turn radius at minimum effort. At half effort, a yawing turn is reduced to 525 meters at 10.4 degrees a second, and at maximum effort, due to a slower forward speed, the Aquila is able to perform a tighter yawing max effort turn at 93 meters. Again, these numbers are not too far off from my 3.0 testing and are likely different due to better testing. Finally, stats that were not included in my 3.0 review, the acceleration and deceleration numbers. In Afterburner, the Aquila takes 29.9 seconds to reach a top speed of 986 meters per second, and this requires 14.7 kilometers. To decelerate, the data is almost identical, separated by only a few meters. Accelerating to maximum SCM at 190 meters per second takes 5.5 seconds and requires 519 meters. Decelerating from SCM takes a little longer at 6.2 seconds and requires 586 meters. These numbers demonstrate why it's important to plan maneuvers in the Aquila, especially for landings and entry into atmosphere. So to wrap things up, the Aquila is still my favorite exploration ship in the game so far, and I don't plan on swapping it out for anything unless something drastic happens.
Your $300 ship is worthless.
While the changes are not huge, some of them are not what I hope to see in future releases, and hope that some of this is just experimentation towards solving problems. For now, the Aquila is definitely still one of my favorite ships, and I'm excited for the future. So let me know what you think in the comments. Will you upgrade to a 600i with CIG's update? I'm Sycamore Omega, and I'll see you again soon. Thanks for watching today's video. Are you new to Star Citizen and are looking to get into the verse? Use the code above to get an extra 5,000 UEC added to your account when you sign up. See you again soon!